Everybody, it's Victa. It's time to continue Intrigue here in the Binding of Isaac Victa Afterbirth Plus series. Thank you, everybody, for the support. You guys and gals absolutely crushed the like streak yesterday on yesterday's video. I'm recording this not even 9 hours after that video went live, so thank you all very much, and also thank you very much for the kind, warm wishes about my good friend Jeff and his passing, which unfortunately happened on this past Saturday. Here's today's meme of the day, here submitted by Cat Weems or Cat Wimes, talking about the D20 run here. All these items are all thanks to the D20. Sackhead, who is the reason why we're getting all these batteries here, says, am I a joke to you? Now, I do have an argument. First off, thank you again to Cat Weems or Cat Wimes. I'm going to say Cat Wimes because that makes a little bit more sense grammatically. And everyone who voted on this on the subreddit /r/Invicta, post the memes down below. Now, for this one here, I do have a little bit of a rebuttal, which I'll get into in a moment. But first, let's go ahead and get this here Isaac Eden run underway. And we'll get started. Is it going to be good? Is it going to be bad? We'll see if we make up for it. Today is going to be Zulu Sierra 6-1, 3 Bravo, 8 Kilo. We've got quad shot, good damage, good movement speed, decent range, good shot speed to start off with, along with the blue hourglass. Interesting. And good HP as well. First the maze. Now, I was talking about my rebuttal for the meme of the day here. Yes, it is true that Sackhead definitely had a pretty big part in the success of the D20. However, I still stand by my justification that the MVP was the D20 because, A, the D20 can make full charges for itself, and B, without the D20, it doesn't matter how many full charges we have, period. So it's kind of like, you know, well, who came first, the chicken or the egg? It's like, well, there wouldn't be a chicken without an egg, but at the same time, you know, there might not be an egg without a chicken. I mean, who really knows? Although, in this metaphor, the chicken would be able to make its own eggs without needing an egg itself, because it can just simply derive one. So, you know, I guess in this case, the chicken came first. I don't know. All I'm trying to say is, thank you, Sackhead. Thank you, D20. You're amazing. Let's talk about this run here. Quad shot, gonna give us a massive tears down, but also give us a huge boost for our damage here. Not because it has any direct effect on our damage, but basically just because we're shooting 4 shots. So, assuming that all targets hit one target, we're essentially quadrupling our DPS. Quad shot's always a great tier effect in pretty much every single case. There are certain situations where you would not want quad shot. Particularly off the top of my head, I can think of Ipecac and Dr. Fetus. But for the most part, quad shot's always going to be a great tier effect. And we'll head on down to the next floor. Good start to this run. Quad shot, of course, is it's pretty ubiquitous with a lot of the most powerful runs that I've ever seen or had. Quad shot's actually fantastic. One item that's made better, infinitely better with quad shot, is Cursed Eye. As silly as that might sound, keep in mind that Cursed Eye doesn't really care what your it actually doesn't care what your tears rate is. As long as you have wow, we even get Guppy's collar in here. As long as you have Cursed Eye, you can just simply charge it up and then you fire off consecutive shots without really having much latency loss. I could have blue hourglass that and done that a little bit better, but I think we'll be all right. I hope we'll be all right. Also got the Parasite, which is going to give us even more fragmentation shots here with all of our shots splintering off like that. Definitely don't want to lose any more soul hearts, however. The D-Izzle. Now, the D8 is interesting here because the D8 could potentially give us a pretty big... Look, first off, D8, you've got some major explaining to do for yourself. Because the last time that we used your D8, you completely screwed us. I'm just saying. So if this is your redemption run, it better be now. It's already nuked our damage once and given us a tears down, which is not good for quad shot. It's not going to make that big of a deal, but one thing is going to make a big deal, of course, is losing a lot of that damage. But, as always with the D8, there's always positives, or not always, most of the time there's positives with the D8, because you can simply just craft the run that you want. If you don't like your stats, then just simply reroll, and then you'll have new stats. It's as simple as that. Whether or not the stats are going to be the ones that you want, or that's a completely different story there, brother. They're seeing here the huge change in our DPS. for the worst. Takes the D8. Hopefully D8 can rectify that situation here. And it gave us a huge tears up and a huge damage up as well. Honestly, I am fine with this. There's a Tendon Rock up there I'll need to go back and get, but this is a huge, huge help. Big time plays, D8, that's what I'm talking about. Pimpin'. Down goes Dingle, and we get ourselves Latch Key, which is going to give us a luck upgrade. And we will take Black Powder here. Black Powder is going to be pretty much useless while we have terrible movement speed, but you never know what we can get. And we'll just head on down. I'm not going to go into the store because we really don't have enough money to make it worthwhile. Our DPS is going to be, or it's not our, it's not going to be, it is massively improved here. And yes, the reduction in movement speed does suck. But I would consider, if this was just a damage upgrade, I would consider re-rolling this one. Just for the sake of our own sanity. Wow, we actually did get a circle there with Black Powder. I mean, it's not a big circle, but you know, it's something more than I thought we'd ever get. But considering that we got not only a huge damage up, but more importantly, we got a tiers up, and a big one at that. We got a 10 tiers up. To me, that's good enough to leave here. We can suffer through the low movement speed for now, and hopefully the game takes care of us and gives us movement speed. Why don't you just take pills, Invicta? I told you we don't take pills unless it's on the seven day streak or seven like streak. All right, that's the term of agreement here that you all have unconditionally and also unconsciously signed. It's non-transferable, non-refundable, something. However the people who made FaceApp, however they got away with that stuff, yeah, like that. Open for a Tinted Rock, but of course we don't find that because we just don't do that here. Actually, Sinvicta, you just got done getting two soul hearts off the first floor in a Tendon Rock, Sinvicta. Alright, well, I mean, that, you know, once in a blue moon, sure. But most of the time, we get golden chests. Someone posted a pretty nice meme the other day with that. Sinvicta finds golden chest. Allow me to introduce ourselves. Or allow us to introduce ourselves. It's like golden. It's like a golden chest, a bomb, and a key. Pretty good. The memes on our subreddit are quite good. Thank you all very much for making those. Movement speed definitely at a premium right now. What would be a perfect movement speed upgrade? Roid Rage or Speedball? I would prefer to get Speedball, because that would give us more shot speed along with a very big movement speed up. Now again, we could also just simply re-roll with the D8, but we're not going to do that here. We can, however, get Mr. Me. And Mr. Me or Compost, what do you do? What do you do here? Well, I am going to take Mr. Me. Can we get Compost first? That's the big question. We cannot. Okay, so we say thank you to the D8 for giving us this. This blessing in disguise, possibly. Hoping for a solid movement speed upgrade eventually. A damage upgrade or a tiers rate upgrade would also not be it would be most welcomed here. Not where the secret room is, huh? See the parasite helping us out there with that shot. Doing that split shot is quite nice for taking out weaker enemies. Of course, Quad Shot also excels at hitting targets that are wide. World card. Well, hold on that for the next floor, because we've already done our standard Sinvicta full clear here. And yeah, we're just gonna get spawned on by the Extendo Net guys, because we move about as fast as a bowl of molasses on a cold day. Something like that, I don't know. It's supposed to get chilly tonight. Not chilly, but it's supposed to be colder tonight. here in Texas. It's supposed to get to an unheard of 64 degrees, which makes no sense, man. Makes no, I mean, I ain't going to complain about it because I absolutely hate the heat, but when the when they released the weather report today, I was like, what? I was like, this has to be incorrect. Let me see what, how, what, what's our temperature right now? Yeah, it's currently 83 right now, so it's still pretty warm. What that is in Celsius, I can't help you Europeans, I'm sorry. I was supposed to get down to 64 tonight, and I'm like, what? That's bonkers, man. Joker card, I'm just going to use it now. So we get an Eternal Heart, which I probably won't take. I don't care about Brother Bobby, nor do I care about my Shade. I do care about getting a Devil Deal item here from Demon Judgment. Or possibly, this is a good opportunity for us. We might be able to get Roid Rage here, which would be great. Come on, Demon Judgment. Get the Rib of Greed, which will guarantee that we don't get a Greed fight for the rest of the run. As long as we hold on to it anyway, which I probably won't because I like having the tarot cards drop. Get Potato Peeler. Get another World card. There we go. We'll take the Eternal Heart. And we have our extra World card. I'm going to save a bomb here by letting Mr. Me open the secret door for us. And I appreciate that, Mr. Me. Thank you very much. Apparently, Mr. Me is a Rick and Morty reference as well. Which is a reference that I have nor will ever get because I never watched the show. I'm not against watching Rick and Morty. It's a show that people said that I would really like. But, like, for judging from all the clips that I've seen in the show, I think it looks kind of dumb. You know, I'm not naive. I am aware of all the backlash to the fan base that it surrounds Rick and Morty, which, you know, I've read all the articles. People are like, you know, the fans actually make Rick and Morty worse, that sort of thing, which is true. A lot of the things that I've seen from the Rick and Morty fan base, the extreme ones. I'm not saying if you're just one of the ones who just like watching the show and you don't go out and act like an idiot in McDonald's, you know, then, you know, more power to you. I'm glad that you don't do that. But it's always the crazy people who are like, you know, they go crazy when they can't have like Szechuan sauce or whatever the heck sauce it was from McDonald's. You know, like those type of people are just not. I don't know how to describe them, but they definitely bring down the quality of the product. Let's put it that way. And you know, you hear a lot more negativity from. About the fan base than you do the show itself. But here's the thing. I've seen clips of the show before I really got sucked into like looking at the fan base going like, oh my God, these guys are like, this is like as bad as like some other fan bases that I won't talk about, but know of. And I didn't think it was funny. I was like this. I always thought that they were trying to parody Back to the Future. I mean, It's clearly supposed to be like a Doc Brown, Marty sort of thing, you know. By the way, if you're wondering what I'm bombing for, I'm trying to get one more penny so we can get a PhD. Because PhD is our salvation here from this just terrible movement speed. 0.53 is real bad. That's something I also kind of forgot about was, why don't you use Mr. Me and Victor? Well, I'm trying not to. I'm trying to guarantee that we get it. But if I have to use Mr. Me, I will. I just want to make sure that, like, if we don't get it with Mr. Me, that we can at least guarantee that we, you know, can get it. We have two chances. But the thing about Rick and Morty is that, man, like, I watched it and I was like, this is just not funny. I mean, they go for, like, the Ren and Stimpy style gross out humor, which is, I mean, you know, that works for some people. I don't really care for it, but, you know, I'm not... judging you either way if you like that sort of thing. It's never been my brand of humor. And they also, I know it's like, oh, it's the smartest TV show on TV. It's, you know, you have to have a so-so IQ level of blah, 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 blah. I mean, you've all seen the memes. No. just need 1 cent, game. Or Mr. Me can help us. He's done it. Friends till the end. This is another friends to the end pill, which we will not be taking. I should go bomb the vanity power pill, okay. Let's bomb the vanity. Bomb the vanity first. I was trying to avoid to go all the way up here just because it's going to take another 10 minutes before we actually go get our world card back. Admittedly, I'm being very lazy here, but I'm trying to get better about that. Seriously, it's something that I've been thinking about lately. Is when I need to get better about leading by example, not by exception. You know, telling you guys and girls, you know, what to do, what not to do, while completely contradicting myself is something I'm trying to improve upon. I could use Mr. Me here, but I'd rather use him against the boss. And we absolutely would have gotten our final penny. And then some. Puberty. We don't really need puberty. I'm just going to go pick up my world card and we'll head on down. Well, I mean, fight the boss and then head on down. The PhD definitely paying out for us here. Hopefully it's worth it. Hopefully we can find ourselves a movement speed pill. Gears up would also be great, of course, but the most important thing for us to replace right now is just the lack of, well, movement speed. I am going to take Nun's Habit because that would allow us to get multiple uses out of Mr. Me. And I will also be buying this full charge, or not full charge, but this full Soul Heart. Not going to get the full charge because we already have one. Let's go fight Le Boss. Now, Mr. Me doesn't do incredible damage, but it does deal some damage. Get blue cap, which is going to give us a tears up, shot speed down, head on down to the next. I'm preparing, or at least I will be preparing soon after this video is done, to rare telepills. We are recording our newest song in the studio today. Actually, at the time of this recording, not right now, but the day that this recording goes out. Basically, by the time you see this video, I'm probably already in the studio prepping stuff and getting ready to lay down the tracks. I have no idea what our new song's called. As ridiculous as that might seem, I just don't know. The song's written, the arrangement's done. We need to lay down the final drum tracks, which I will be doing along with the vocals tomorrow. Everything's getting done tomorrow. I've booked the studio for the entire day. And if you're interested in hearing the tracks, of course, you can go check it out. It'll be globally released here on YouTube with an accompanying release on my Bandcamp page. It's invicta.bandcamp.com. And you can go check that out. If you want to get it a week early before the rest of the world does, you can sign up on my Patreon. It's a great way to support myself and the band. Most of the money that we get on Patreon, I fund into the band stuff. I pay partial fees anyway out of the Patreon. I say partial because not because I'm trying to hold on to the profits for myself or anything like that and get rich off of the $400, $500 or so that's on there right now, but it doesn't currently cover the cost of studio production, which has gone up and up and up over the years. Since we're steadily increasing the I don't know what this pill is. Who would have thought I would have ever used this to get a pill? It's Lemon Party. Lemon Party is not terrible, but it's also not what we want. Let's go take a quick gander here. Okay. I'm gonna be kind of salty if we don't get a movement speed upgrade. Just one. Just one movement speed upgrade would be plenty. I mean, anything is going to be an improvement over what we have right now. So I'm going to hold on to this Perthrow rune for a devil deal in hopes that we get, like, something good out of it. I mean, quad shot's still good. Let's not get it twisted now. Quad shot's still good. Multidimensional baby gives us a shot speed upgrade, technically, if we shoot through it, but we don't need a shot speed upgrade. We need a movement speed upgrade. Because I don't know if you notice this or not here, but we're moving real slow. And I mean real slow.
Sedicta, it's your fault you're moving so slow. You didn't have to take it, Sedicta. You could have just used the D8, Sedicta.
Yeah, but, like, you know, the combined efforts of us possibly having PhD getting rid of this movement speed problem, combined with the fact that it was early on, I mean, you know, I'm so happy with our damage. Any damage that we get, is, damage up-wise, is going to be huge. Because it's going to be magnified by a whole lot. We got Athame. We did get a deal with the devil. I Perthrowed that. I forgot that I Perthrowed rune until I packed out. And Curse the Blind. That's what I get for not using the Perthrowed rune. All right. What I get. That was one of those times when, like, you could just see it working in my brain without you even being able to see me. Curse the tower, might as well try. Hey. I mean, I knew the secret room was there. I was what I was referring to as, like, we might as well try to hit said secret room with one of the random bombs that drops from the Curse the Tower. Now, hopefully we get lucky enough to get another deal with the devil here, but if we don't, I really don't have anyone to blame but myself for not using the Perthrow rune. Yeah, the arrangement's been done. It's definitely our most technically difficult song and mechanically difficult song we've ever written. Mark and I were going for a particular vibe in this one, and we definitely hit it. So I'm very interested to see what the reaction from people is going to be. I don't need to help that prince till the end, sure. And party. See forever. But I think that Mark and I really nailed this one down. I don't know what Nick's gonna do with the vocals. I don't know how much singing or screaming I'm gonna be doing tomorrow. It's probably gonna be a little bit of both, like I said. Either way, I've gotta rest up my voice. And that's gonna be another dead end here. Every dead end is magnified by If our damage is magnified by a multitude of multiple of four or a factor of four, then our travel time is magnified by a magna four of that. I don't know what this is. It's going to be Bloody Lust, which is a great item. Would not have rerolled that, so that's good to know. And I just want to see what's in the store, if there is one over here. The Tinted Rock is actually a double Tinted Rock over here. We've been seeing a lot of double Tinted Rocks lately. How do you differentiate between a regular Tinted Rock or a double Tinted Rock? Double Tinted Rocks will have this sort of the inverted X there. Inverted in the colors, I mean. So this X is much, much whiter and lighter shade than the regular X's that you see. And that will denote a double Tinted Rock, which is going to give us even more movement speed down. Because, I mean, hell, why not, right? You know? I mean, what's the difference between 0.10 more of movement speed? You know? Yeah, I mean, you know, why try to work? Why try to move so fast in this workday world of ours? You know, Book of Belial, sure. Book of Sin, why not? I'm going to hold on to the Book of Sin. We could use Mr. Me to get out of the boss rush, but unfortunately we have no way of getting into said boss rush. So unless we actually find Mama Mega, which is unlikely, then, well, Mr. Me really serves no more purpose to us. You want the soul heart, but more importantly, I want to see what this is. Black candle, of course, would be amazing. The blanket's not bad either. Like, it's going to give us the Holy Mantle effect every time we walk into a boss room, but it only lasts for the duration of said boss room, and regardless or not, if we get hit, we lose the holy mantle upon leaving the room. And I've got to say that this is certainly, without question, one of the lowest movement speeds I've ever seen.
Not allowed to complain about it, Invicta.
I'm just saying, I know what bed I made for this run. I made my bed, now I'm laying in it. We knew that we were gonna be slow. However, I was not expecting it to be this slow. Taking Fat Odd Mushroom after getting a massive movement speed down and then getting Small Rock and then deciding to take Small Rock, not always a smart idea. I didn't say it was a smart idea. I'm saying I'm an idiot for doing it in the first place. But I'm still holding out hope. I'm really holding out hope that our good friend PH Dizzle will reward me for having faith in it and providing us with a speed up pill. A curse. We may be taking the black rune here. If anything, just to take the black rune to the freaking chest so we can get a chance for a movement speed up. I'm going to hold on to Perthrow for now, of course, because we're almost, well, let's not get it twisted here. We're not almost guaranteed of having a, we might as well. Crack die, okay. Soul Heart. Crack die is essentially the same thing as the Perthrow rune, except it also has the D20 in the mix. That's another dead end. Every dead end, man. Every dead end is just going to be like nails on a chalkboard. And I'm going to be kind of upset with myself if we end up finding the other dead end here. Not a dead end, but I literally can't move. I literally cannot have... We would have died. We would have died in that room. I'm not even playing this up. We do not have the movement speed to fight against vortex mobs, and you can't destroy those without euthanasia. So we could, if those were permanent, I'm as serious as a heart attack right now. If those vortex statues were permanent, we would have lost the streak because I literally could not move. Oh, good. Got a range upgrade. We get Maw of the Freaking Void. Plan C, which I will not be taking. And I will also not be taking that. I am going to go all the way back to go get the Black Rune, however. We get Maw of the Void, and Maw of the Void with... Yes, I did forget about this room. Maw of the Void with this tier delay is going to be quite laborious to use effectively, but it's worth it. It's still worth it in my opinion. Okay, remember, don't go in here until after the current shut off. And go. Okay. Scariest room in the entire game right there. That's probably what I put on the thumbnail, to be honest. Okay. Got some pills here. I can see forever. Friends of the End Lemon Party and Power Pill again. Hey man, don't blame me. I don't want to hear it. I don't want to hear it. I don't want to hear about, oh, well, can you make pills and dicta? This is why. Even when you get PhD, you still can't get stat ups. That's why I don't take pills right there. You want to know how bad pills are? Because even when you have an item that forces them to be negative or positive, or not negative, but neutral or positive, you still can't get positive pills. That's why I don't take pills. I don't know what the heck was going on with Multidimensional Baby there. He was misdirecting our split shot from Parasite, and they were receiving the shot speed and range bonus from Multidimensional Baby. That's kind of weird. That's cool. That's kind of weird. So the next time you're hanging out with your girl, or your guy, or your significant other, and you're sitting there wondering yourself, how come Invicta doesn't take pills? That's why. And the answer, for those of you who don't know, is that pills are so bad, even when you have something that forces them to be positive or neutral, they're still negative. You don't get stat ups. You don't get stat ups with salad. You don't get stats with salad. It should be just stats. You don't get stats with salad. You don't get stats with salad. Oh, that's an old Simpsons reference. Now, do we need to be using Maw of the Void here? No. But I can't fight the temptation not to. There's absolutely no way I'm going to be fighting Hush. Not with this build. Not with this movement speed. I'm honestly a little surprised. I mean, from a get trolled nerd standpoint, I'm not surprised. But from like a logistical and educated standpoint about everything I know about this game, I am surprised that we have not seen a single movement speed upgrade. But me being me and knowing how the game loves to troll me, I'm not surprised that we did not see a single movement speed upgrade, despite us having PhD and hoping for a speed up pill. Isn't that always just what they call, what was it called? Let me think about it. Oh yeah, it's called Invicta Luck. I am the anti-razor. Occam's Razor never saw me coming. The most obvious and clearest advantage point that you can have is never going to happen. The logical outcome of my luck has been predetermined long ago. Back before the Earth was old. I was young. How it goes. It's supposed to be I was old when the Earth was old. Was young. Look, I'm tired. I went to bed. I got into it with Arc-Tempered Nergigante on Monster Hunter World. And I was like, it was one of those times where, like, I was so groggy that I wasn't playing very well. But I was also getting, like, ticked off that I was not playing very well. So, and in classic me fashion, I'm like, Well, I'm not going to bed till this is happening, no matter what. Like, I'm going to kill this boss before I go to bed. Well, I didn't get to bed until 10:30 in the morning. It's not because I suck at Monster Hunter, but it's because I was streaming at the time, and streaming's really where the problem lies for me in terms of my sleep schedule. And so the end. Still have not found... We have not gained a single stat up from PhD. That's pretty amazing. Apparently you can shoot in front of you, but shoot behind you. Soul Heart, thank you very much. We were able to skip the angel piece. There's no way. There's no way we can outrun these beams, man. Just don't even try, Isaac. You're better off just standing still. Just stand still and hope. There we go. We got down Isaac thanks to our DPS. Oh! But we have one chance. We have one chance of getting a stat up here. By stat up, I mean movement speed up. Can we get it?
Heard you need movement speed. Well, here's every other stat, loser. Enjoy, nerd. Get trolled, nerd. Enjoy all the dead ends, loser.
I'm glad that people finally are starting to get upset at the game for just doing me dirty all the time. Like the latest, surprisingly, one of the tipping points for this whole thing was yesterday's run when I was trying to make boss rush, and people were saying how ridiculous the map was. And I'm like, oh yeah, it sucks. Trust me, it sucks. People were actually getting upset that the game was trolling so hard with that map, and that map was terrible. But come on, like that one's also, this one's also got to kind of piss you off a little bit, right? I mean, the Black Rune, it allocates everything randomly. What are the chances? What are the chances that not one of those four stat ups was going to land on speed? Not a single one of them landed on speed. And another dead end. Well, we got a speed up. A 0.06 speed up. Thanks, Austin. We have, how many stats are affected by Black Rune? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There's 6 stats that are affected by Black Runes. We just needed to hit one of them. I'm not going to D4 this. At this point, I feel like we just kind of need to end it with this. Well, let's just complete the cycle sort of thing, you know? But I am tempted to reroll it. But I think that would make our suffering all for naught at that point.
I can take Shield of Tears, Invicta.
I don't really need Shield of Tears, Timmy. And I just wanted the movement speed upgrade is all. I just wanted us to see. I wanted us to have a better shot at movement speed upgrade. Get another dead end.
Told you, nerd. Here's another one for you. Sorry.
We got double sucked in by Mega Fatties there. That wasn't me moving like downhill, by the way. That was us getting double sucked by both of the Mega Fatties. Took him a while. It was even better than the High Priestess. Faux show. Yep.
Told you.
All right, and so begins our 20-minute trek to walking towards the other side of the map to hopefully not get another dead end. Since we're here, we might as well just go get this one out of the way real fast. I mean, we're still going to win this run. Like, there's no doubt about it. Like, this run was over. So the second that we got quad shot, this run was over. Got pretty fly. It's just comical. It really is comical at how unsurprising the most ridiculous trolls are in this game that we get. You know, it's so commonplace by now on my channel. People are just like, yeah, just, I mean, that's just Invicta. Don't expect them to have good luck. If you expect Simic to have any sort of good luck, it's not happening. Actually, Simic, I calculated it, and you actually have the same amount of luck that we do, okay? If you say so there, boss. There we go. So we did it. We technically got a speed upgrade, I guess, at the very end in the form of Dogtooth. But I challenge you to find anyone who's like, which one of the better speed upgrades you can get? Well, Dogtooth is. Guarantee you no one's going to be saying Dogtooth is one of the better speed upgrades. Anyway, thank you for watching, everyone. I hope you enjoyed this one. It was a, It certainly was. That certainly was a thing.